This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Look around.
We are known as the Currier and Ives Corner of New Hampshire.
And listen.
It's a mill village that still functions. How'd that happen?
If these covered bridges could talk, they'd say, ouch. If locals don't understand Tom Hasselman...
Oh, everybody thinks I'm a little nuts for doing it.
It's because of his home.
My yurt. I'm in the woods with my yurt.
The company that grew like gangbusters.
Just a viral t-shirt that just exploded on the internet.
The farm that grows hope.
Manual labor is good, good therapy.
The main streets and back roads of New Hampshire's Monadnock region, next on Chronicle.
New Hampshire's Cheshire County.
We've often been viewed as the forgotten corner, way off in the southwest corner of New Hampshire.
At its heart, the city of Keene, probably best known for Keene State College and the city's brush with Hollywood as the backdrop for the 1995 Robin Williams movie, Jumanji. And there was one more claim to fame, explains Alan Rumrill of the County Historical Society.
Our main street is now 166 feet wide, and in the early 1900s, the town voted to pave Main Street. They sent out postcards and advertised that we had the widest paved Main Street in the world, so you had to come and visit Keene. I don't think they really did any research. It's not anymore.
Of course, when Keene started out back in the 1700s, there were no streets at all.
The original European settlers who came here to farm, so they were farming the land, even though it's pretty rough terrain throughout.
Farming eventually gave way to manufacturing, but that didn't last either, leaving old-time New England pretty much intact.
We are known as the Currier and Ives Corner of New Hampshire because when the farms and the industries left, many of the small towns were never developed, so there were no changes.
And that's exactly the story of nearby, picture-perfect Harrisville, frozen in time. It's a mill village that still functions. How'd that happen?
Woolen textiles started here around 1820 by the Harris family. My family started an operation in Keene. In 1849, they moved here and competed with the Harrises in this village. The Harrises left the industry and the village in the late 1880s, and my family stayed until 1970 when the mill closed.
John Colony grew up in Harrisville. With the closing, he knew that something very special was about to be lost, both the mill and the classic village it supported. The year was 1970.
The mill here closed, along with 53 other mills in New England that year. It was a big falling out time for textiles. And the reason the mills closed at that time was because of double knit fabrics. Everything was being double knitted for the first time, and all the weaving mills stopped.
Harrisville closed, but only for a few months. John and his friends had an idea, a two-part concept to save the village and its industry.
Harrisville Designs is the textile side of it. Historic Harrisville is the building and redevelopment side of it.
They've preserved 20-plus buildings, not as a museum, but as a real, working, living community. Erin Hammerstedt is in charge.
We have quite a mix. We have 10 residential properties that we have different individuals and families in. And then we have some of our key tenants, the Harrisville General Store, which we operate, is an anchor. We also have the United States Post Office, Harrisville Children's Center, some of those core community functions. And then we have businesses.
And that's where the other part of the preservation plan comes in. Harrisville Designs is John's wool spinning business. His end product, yarn.
So you've heard the expression, dyed in the wool? Well, this is it. You start with your raw wool and you dye it various colors, blue, green, yellow, and you mix it to the color you want. You blend all these colors until you get, let's say in this case, a purple color you want. And the wool is dyed in the wool. The color goes all the way through.
From the mixing machine, the wool is fed into this vintage 1924 carding machine that lines the fibers up and separates them into bands of wool that are then twisted into yarn. From there, the many strands of yarn are wound onto big bobbins. This next device is called a skein winder. It measures off the length of yarn, which depends on its weight, either 50 or 100 grams. But wait, there's more. Harrisville Designs doesn't just make yarn, they build looms as well. And here are the finished products, loom and yarn, working together in an old-fashioned factory store right on site at the Harrisville Mill Village.
I remember when we first started, there was a fellow who lived in town. He gave us a little quote. He said, Harrisville's worth saving, not because it's old, but because it's good.
And I noticed that some water was still running under those old mills. Are they working still?
Well, the ability to use water to generate electricity has been offline there for generations. But. They're bringing it back. They've actually ordered a hydroelectric generator. That's going to be arriving before too long. And pretty soon, water will be powering the mills in Harrisville again.
That's great. Lee Dunham tends to bruise-covered bridges.
They post that sign with the height for a reason.